last thing left in nature is female beauty. I mean, that's about what we've got left. The last thing left in nature is female beauty. The last thing left in nature is female beauty. The last thing left in nature is female beauty. Left in nature is female beauty. I mean, that's about what we've got left. The heightened female attractiveness is the last little hint of nature remaining. We're left with the beauty of women, and that's about it.
God give us all to partake. Why can't we just learn to
the last thing left in nature is female beauty. I mean, that's about what we've got left. The last thing left in nature is female beauty. The last thing left in nature is female beauty. The last thing left in nature is female beauty. The last thing left in nature is wilderness. You can forget it. Nature is last little hint of nature remaining.
What?
I say, as I see it, we're left with the beauty of women, and that's about it.
You really believe that?
Yes, I do.
That's very interesting. It's a powerful statement.
Well, I don't know about powerful.
No, it is. I'm a woman. It's like coming to me very powerfully.
And what are you going to do? Go to a clapped out New Jersey safari park or Nairobi National Park and watch a bunch of stress and density ridden animals sort of exhibit their displacement behavior as human beings, sort of lean out of their crappy little Volkswagen and yell and try and take their stupid pictures.
What a great visual.
It's a long way from New York, you know. It's the heart of darkness. It's falling. It's collapsing. It's way, way, way back there, you know. We're imposing upon it all of our superficial plastic galloping rot formulas. None of them work, and it's subsiding quickly. Well, it's getting more dangerous because the deeper human beings go into the forests and the more they cut down, the more they're exposing themselves to these unknown viruses that have been there for centuries, eons, and it's getting very dangerous. HIV is just one. There are going to be many. We've exceeded the carrying capacity of every habitat we've touched.
Exactly.
We're operating on our own greedy, selfish human formulas, and we're in violation of nature's laws. We're at war with nature, so we think we're better. We're not, and we're going to lose. We're just going to suffer. I'm into the holographic universe. I'm into the extra-dimensional possibilities, but I think the desperation on Earth, on the global habitat, is going to reach an amazing peak before our frequencies rise to the level where we can see how little of life we understand and how little of mathematics and physics we have even begun to discover.
So what do you think, Peter, as far as...
I don't know what to think, but I know we're not doing a good job. We are in as much trouble as we are distant from nature.
Yeah.
We have shown no signs of understanding nature or even understanding reality. I just know that things aren't working, and I just read an enormous article in the New Yorker about these new viruses that are coming out of the forest, and they are absolutely the result of human interference, human greed, human penetration, human violation of nature's laws, and they're very, very serious. These are very serious germs. They're density dependent. Every 4 days, we add 1 million people onto the Earth.
Mm-hmm.
250,000 people are added every day. This can't go on. The exponential curve is shocking. It took roughly 2.5, 3.5 million years for human beings to reach a population of 1 billion in the middle of the 19th century. And now we add 1 billion people every decade. The curve is preposterous.
Is anyone addressing any of this properly,
nope.
Adequately?
Nope.
No.
No. Nope. Clinton understands. Clinton is not against abortion. We need agents of mortality. Human beings need to be cut back. We are voracious, rapacious, greedy bastards.
When you say cut back, do you mean controlled?
We need, at the most, 2.1 people per family. Kenya averages 8.2 children per female. Madagascar averages 11.2. The third world is going to eat us alive.
Yeah.
It's an avalanche.
So what more?
The absurdity of aid programs and food aid is preposterous because more food means more people. Do-gooders are doing bad. The whole business of milking the guilty, rich world that has ripped off its resources.
God.
It's paradoxical. It is
possible.
It is not working. It is a disaster. It's all going to work out, but it's going to be very, very painful. There's going to be a lot of suffering because...
How is it going to work
400
out?
To 400 to 500 million people are starving to death annually. This is not pleasant. It's like the elephants of Tsavo.
Mm-hmm.
Their habitat is limited, finite. It cannot support the exponential expansion.
So what more, Peter?
Well, you know, we're running out of resources. We have to reconsider, rethink, re-educate.
Where is this going to come from?
Failure. What?
Yeah, but where is that going to come from? You know how badly
unenlightened... I don't think it's going to come from our leaders.
No, they're unenlightened at that level.
Our leaders are for votes. Our leaders
yes,
are for the people.
Exactly.
People is the problem.
Yeah, this is a different consciousness. So how does one get that consciousness raised?
I think it will be raised in a direct ratio. The degree it's too late.
Yeah.
It happens, but it happens in proportion to the...
severity.
Exactly.
Where does that come from? A lack of spirit? A lack of what?
There's lack of education, lack of understanding.
So you think it's a...
knowledge of nature's laws. We have lost enormous amounts of everything. We don't know who we are.
Exactly.
We're having an identity trauma. We think we are so great, and we're as great as we are dangerous. We're very dangerous. We adapt to the damage we cause. We're like elephants.
Yeah.
We can eat the last tree 300 miles away because we can live on dust and driftwood and scraps and garbage.
It's amazing, you know, it's like a roach. We constantly are readapting.
Well, a roach is about 300 million years older than us. Mm-hmm. We're new. We're about maximum 3 million years old. And we're already disastrous. We're pushing it to the edge. The Russian scientists last year estimated 16 years left before fatally irreversible global environmental damage. I think we've gone too far.
Well,
we've made life boring and plastic and artificial and far from the diversity of nature, which is what spells survival. We're just completely sort of cement-like and monstrous.
So is there anything else, Peter, you'd like to really say or, you know, enlighten us on?
The nomadic strategy has been extincted by our speed and our stupidity. And when you talk about nomads, you talk about an endangered species that barely exists. It's like a rhino. It might as well be in a zoo.
And regardless of any of the information that's been handed down, for some reason, it's not infiltrating. Why do you think that is?
Politicians are leading the world. Politicians need votes. Politicians have to love people. Politicians work for people. Politicians lie to people. Politicians are liars.
Mm-hmm. Is there anyone in this world that you have any kind of sensitivity to, what they're doing, what they're trying for, whatever?
I like Dalai Lama. He's looking good.
He's looking good.
I think so, yeah. Compassion's all we have left against odds. Understanding. You have to try and understand why this disease is so unstoppable.
You mean the human condition disease?
The human horror. The horror, the horror.
And how do we describe ourselves? We always describe ourselves in these great terms. What you're saying...
Egotistical, selfish, greedy, megalomaniac. Human locus.
Feeding until the end.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
Maggots scratching and killing each other for that last little morsel, molecule of flesh, getting those bones all white and slimy.
God. What is that kind of animal that eats itself? What is that?
Well, they say hyenas do, but...
This is worse than a hyena. Is there anything...
Well, it's a phenomenon. Phantasmagoria.
Yeah.
The thing about the nomadic strategy is that whenever aid money, whenever help from the outside world comes in, mm-hmm. they dig boreholes, they put water in, they put permanent settlement financing. That is a death blow. The Bushmen, Somalis, Turkana, Maasai, they've all been eradicated by this policy of what's called aid. Do-gooders aid, the lords of poverty. Do-gooders are doing bad. Aid is not working. Aid is a long-term weapon. We are a deadly enemy. Our help is pulling the rug out from under those we're theoretically trying to help. God knows. It's hard to believe we even think it's helping because the record is so clear. If you read the arms race, the history of American voluntary aid abroad, or the lords of poverty, mm-hmm. the power, the prestige, and the corruption of the international aid industry, you can immediately find out what a death blow these helping hands are. As righteous as their intentions are,
mm-hmm.
they come from the guilt-ridden, spoiled world that has basically ripped off its resources and is misapplying the abundant guilt with benevolence that destroys the infrastructure and the people related to it.
You're talking aid doesn't work. What does work?
I say aid has not worked.
Has not worked. Not in the way in which it's being delivered.
The only thing I can see right now is birth control. Birth control, I'm a parasite off good subject matter. I don't mind anything. I like to record things. I like to record everything.